Combination of errors. We know that when we are engaged in an experiment, measurement of several physical quantities is involved. And we might have to do certain mathematical operations that combine these physical quantities. For example, if we have to find area of a particular object, we know that it involves the dimensions of length and breadth. Suppose we have to find area of a rectangular object in an experiment, then we know that the physical quantity length will be having an error as well as breadth will be having an error. And therefore, area will have an error as a combination of these two errors. So this is about combination of errors, that is, whenever we are involving some mathematical operations, there might occur combination of errors of certain physical quantities. The procedure that we follow in such mathematical operations are as follows. The first operation that we consider is the sum and difference. We are going to see how to find error of a sum or a difference. Suppose we are having two physical quantities, A and B, with absolute errors delta A and delta B respectively. And we have to find a third quantity Z, which is the sum of both physical quantities A and B. Since both A and B have errors in it, definitely the third quantity Z, which is the sum of these two, will have error in it. We represent it as Z plus or minus delta Z is equal to, along with error in A and B, we can write this as A plus or minus delta A plus B plus or minus delta B, which can be written as A plus B plus or minus delta A plus or minus delta B. So delta Z may have values of plus or minus delta A plus or minus delta B. So from this we can say that the maximum value of the error delta Z can be delta A plus delta B. The maximum error that can occur is delta A plus delta B. Thus, the maximum possible error in our quantity Z is obtained as delta A plus delta B. Now, coming to the difference, then our third quantity Z will be A minus B. Now, including the error, we can write Z plus or minus delta Z is equal to A plus or minus delta A minus B plus or minus delta B, which can be written as A minus B plus or minus delta A plus or minus delta B. So here also we can say that the maximum value of delta Z can be delta A plus delta B. So the maximum possible error occurring while we take the difference is maximum delta Z is equal to delta A plus delta B. So in both addition and difference, that is both sum and difference, the maximum delta Z value will always be delta A plus delta B. So as a rule for addition and subtraction or sum and difference, we can say that when two quantities are added or subtracted, the absolute error in final result is sum of absolute error in individual quantities. Now we are going to see the error of product or quotient. For that, our quantity Z will be A into B. That is product of physical quantities A and B. Now to know the absolute error in Z, we take Z plus or minus delta Z as A plus or minus delta A into B plus or minus delta B. In the place of A, we have taken the quantity including the absolute error, and in the place of B, we have taken the quantity including its absolute error as well. Now, taking the product of these two, we get AB plus or minus A delta B plus or minus B delta A plus or minus delta A into delta B. And we know that absolute error is a very small quantity, and product of two absolute errors will be further smaller, and therefore we can neglect this value, which will be very small value, that is delta A into delta B. Thus, z plus or minus delta z can be written as AB plus or minus A delta B plus or minus B delta A. Now, next we are going to divide throughout this equation by AB. We know that AB is z itself. On dividing by AB, that is by z, we get 1 plus or minus delta z by z is equal to 1 plus or minus delta b by b plus or minus delta a by a. Thus, here we get an expression for the relative error in the quantity z as plus or minus delta b by b plus or minus delta a by a. From this, we can say that the maximum value in the relative error, which will be the sum of the positive values, that is maximum relative error, can be written as delta z by z is equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. Thus, for the case of product, we obtain the expression for maximum relative error as this, and for division also the maximum relative error will be same. Thus, we can write the rule as, when two physical quantities are multiplied or divided, the relative error in the result is sum of relative errors in each quantities. As we have seen here, the relative error in the result is the sum of relative errors of each physical quantities. So, this is the rule that we follow for multiplication and division of two physical quantities. Now, we also know that in the experiments we do, the mathematical operations also involve the physical quantities raised to a power. So, the next case that we are going to consider is the error in case of measured quantity raised to a power. For that, we are taking an example. Let z be a to the power 2, that is a square. So, we can see that z is equal to a square means a into a. Now, it has become the product between a and a. Therefore, the relative error in z, based on the product rule, we can write as relative error in a plus relative error in a, which can be written as 2 delta a by a. So, for a physical quantity raised to power 2, we obtain the relative error as 2 delta a by a. So, we have seen that error is the power times the relative error of the physical quantity. Thus, in general, we can write, for a z which is equal to a to the power p, b to the power q divided by c to the power r, we can write the relative error in the quantity z as delta z by z is equal to p times relative error in a plus q times relative error in b plus r times relative error in c. So, this is how we express the relative error for the case of exponential.